Hi, we're here with Curtis Sliwa, Republican candidate for mayor right outside Brooklyn Borough Hall. He's about to give a press conference on Eric Adams and the Corrections Department, and Eric Adams being out in the Hamptons. But on local issues that affect the Village Sun, one that springs to mind is Washington Square Park. Policing was an issue there. Regularly, they're enforcing the closing now regularly with some soft policing. There were issues, you know, for months with loud noise, amplified music, crowds, fireworks, drugs, motorcycles. And I think you were saying Tompkins Square Park, there's a precedent there and how that was handled.
Well, just one correction. I'm the Republican candidate, but I'm also running on the independent party line.
Okay.
So people who have a second opportunity.
Independence or independent?
Independent, since remember Cuomo wiped out all the third parties. There's an independent line that I got signatures for.
Oh.
That's what it's called, independent line.
You created that line?
Yes.
Okay.
By properly getting the signatures. But I'm a veteran of Tompkins Square Park. I lived right across the street, Avenue A, St. Mark's Place. And that's when David Dinkins himself imposed a curfew and put a fence around Tompkins Square Park because anarchy was prevailing. There was wild activity going on morning, noon, and night. And that helped control the whole area, so much so that people could use the park when it was necessary and the park was closed so that others would not just flood into it and make life miserable for everyone around.
It's a perimeter fence?
The perimeter fence.
There wasn't really a large, tall fence?
Well, it was a large fence because when I got attacked with baseball bats in April of 1992, I was able to get over the fence. That's what saved my life. That's how much I remember it.
Okay.
But
it was lower. It was lower, a lower fence?
No, it was a high fence. Okay. It was about a good 20-foot fence around. In fact, there are pictures of it.
Okay.
That was a successful program put into place by a liberal mayor similar to de Blasio. But at least there was a consistent message. The problem with de Blasio is one minute there's a curfew, next minute there's not a curfew, one minute there's enforcement, next minute no enforcement. And people, they have to be told, okay, how can we use the park, when can we use it, and more importantly, what is doable and what isn't doable. And the police are always being played like a yo-yo.
Mm.
One minute they're coming in with body armor, batons, you know, we call them bats and hats, they're like ready for riot, you say, really? And then the next minute, they're out of sight, out of mind.
Right.
So people don't know what to take from that. And there's so many outsiders who've used Washington Square Park for years, it's a beautiful park, that I remember in the early 80s. Mudd, Pastor Mudd, actually brought us in there. We had a headquarters in the basement of Judson Memorial Church. In fact, that's where I got married to Lisa at that time.
Mudd or Moody?
That's right, Moody, I'm sorry. And we patrolled that whole area for a long time to help keep it quiet because it was getting very raucous. Nowhere near what we're seeing now. My concern is people who are injecting and dying in the park.
Right.
You would think there would be immediate intervention.
Right.
Drug intervention specialists. It doesn't require cops, but I don't see it happening, and I'm in that park often.
Actually, Gail Brewer has been a leader on this, the borough president, in getting social services, and there are apparently social services in there 7 days a week, and yet the New York Post just had an article the other day saying, you know, like 7 overdose deaths in the last week or so, and we have a photographer got a picture of a syringe on the ground. East Villagers are saying they're seeing a lot of... on social media, they're seeing a lot of heroin and injection drug, you know. It seems to be worsening right now.
It's so plentiful. Heroin is cheap.
Yeah.
Fentanyl is even cheaper.
Mm-hmm.
And then they cut heroin with fentanyl, which is a recipe for potential death.
Right.
And then the worst drug of all, though it's going to cause somebody to lapse into an uncontrolled state over time, is K2.
Right.
You smoke that, it's a dollar a joint. And neurologically, it really begins to impact you like crack. So you start combining all these drugs, and they're being openly used, openly sold. And people know they can come into Washington Square Park. They can purchase it. They can use it. And unfortunately, many of them are getting very sick. Some of them are actually expiring.
That's synthetic marijuana, K2?
Well, they call it synthetic marijuana, but anybody who's used marijuana knows it has nothing to do with marijuana. It's basically leaves.
Yeah.
They chemically spray it. Most of it comes in from Paterson, New Jersey, where the toxic chemicals are stored in basements.
Mm.
And then they just lay these leaves out, spray it, put it in baggies. Commercially, it's still manufactured in Georgia with brand names. And you say, how can that be? But it is.
Right.
And it's led to an epidemic use. Cheap, plentiful, and people begin to lose control of their mental faculties because of it.
Well, I mean, so what should be done in terms of maybe, you know, increasing injection drug use and K2 in the village area, for example? What should be done?
Well, they can't have it both ways. Yeah. So you either have zero tolerance, or if you're going to talk specifically about heroin or fentanyl, you have injection centers, which some people have spoken about. But then you better give them the drugs, because all the drug dealers are going to be around the injection centers. And where are the people going to get the money to buy the drugs in order to be safely injected in an injection center to make sure they don't have HIV, make sure they don't have all other kinds of problems as a result of their own injections, hepatitis C, all kinds of sores, you name it.
Right.
So either give them the drug for free,
right,
and go the whole nine yards, but don't put an injection center in, because all you're going to have is a cluster of drug dealers, and then the junkies are going to go through the neighborhood. They're going to go into all kinds of stores. They're going to be shoplifting, stealing, because they got to feed the beast, which is their habit.
Or like, what about West 4th Street and 6th Avenue? There's kind of like a little cluster of homeless guys there that are, some of them are doing crack and whatnot. I think the restaurants there have some frustration, like the Weverly Diner. They hired their own private security, but I guess there's protections. If you want to be a homeless guy in the street, you're protected to a certain extent. Like, I think Ron Kuby, your former partner, or Norman Siegel, I think maybe it was Norman Siegel, has done some cases on this, that, you know, people have the right to sleep on the street as long as they're not blocking traffic. So,
well, if they have issues, those issues need to be dealt with.
Right,
and
by
most
outreach.
Most of the men and women have the issues, and they're not being dealt with. And I challenge any...
Why is that? Why are they not being dealt with?
Well, because there's no immediate involvement of the city, which has the resources to help them.
Is the police sort of
help? No, you don't
hands
need
off?
The police involved. Yeah, I mean, look, they don't want the police involved. Let's see how they can do it themselves. They've been a miserable failure. They told the cops to back off, but who do they have in place of the cops? Nobody.
Isn't there an Upper West Side program where they're getting some social services to respond first, and then the police back them up?
I gotta be honest with you, I live on the Upper West Side. I'm out in the streets all the time there. I haven't seen it.
I think it's a little north of the, maybe it's more like Morningside Heights.
Well, on 96th Street up to where Columbia University is, I'm through that area, Frederick Douglass Projects. I don't see that.
Right.
But let me take care of business here.
Okay, thank you, Curtis.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Okay.